Hello, my dear students. I welcome you all to my English class. Today, we are going to see how to use there is and there are at the beginning of the sentences. Yesterday, we have done the same question, and today, again, we are going to practice some more new sentences. That is how to begin the sentence with there is and there are. So children, let's start. Now children, we are on page number 102. We have the same question here to use there is and there are. Read these sentences. There is a notice on the wall. A notice, that means one. S is not there, so a notice on the wall. So for one thing, we have used there is. And the next one, there are many swings in the park. Many means more than one. Swings, again S is there, that means more than one. So we have used here, there are many swings in the park. Now let's see what we have to do here. Now complete these sentences with there is or there are. The first one is already been done for you. There are some insects under the leaves. Some means more than one. Insects again means more than one. That is, S is there means more than one insects. So we have used here there are. Okay, now come to the second one, children. Now here is the second one. Dash a mouse behind the chair. Dash a mouse behind the chair. So how many mouse is there? S is there? No. S is not there, that means one. Dash a mouse behind the chair. So what we are going to use for one mouse? There is. I-S is. So we will write here T-H-E-R-E. There. I-S is. There is a mouse behind the chair. Okay, a mouse means one mouse. There is a mouse behind the chair. Now come to the third one. Dash a few bottles of water here. Children, don't get confused because A is written here. A means one, but few bottles. Few means more than one, and bottles, again S is there, so that also means more than one. But when we say few, we also use a with it. A few bottles. Okay, so a few bottles. Few means more than one, and again S, wherever S is there, that means it is more than one. So we are going to use here A R E R T H E R E there. A-R-E-R. There are a few bottles of water here. Okay. And the fourth one. Dash a railway station behind our house. A railway station. Can you see any S over here? No. A railway station means one railway station. So we'll write here. There is a railway station behind our house, because there is only one railway station. And the fifth one. Dash a rock in the middle of the road. Again, a rock, S is not there. A rock means one. So we will write here I-S is. T-H-E-R-E there. I-S is. There is a rock in the middle of the road. Now come to the sixth one. Dash many mangoes on the tree. So how many mangoes are there? Many. Mangoes, S is there, so it is more than one. Many mangoes, M-A-N-G-O-E-S. So that means it is more than one. Many also means more than one. So what are we using for more than one? There are. There are many mangoes on the tree. There are many mangoes on the tree. Okay, so remember children, what you have to see whether S is there or not after the word. S means more than one. Okay, if the thing is more than one, then we are going to use A-R-E-R. And if we are talking about only one thing or one people, then we are going to write I-S-Is. Okay, I repeat, there is a mouse behind the chair. There are a few bottles of water here. I repeat here children, few bottles means more than one. Okay, don't get confused because it is written a here. With few, we use the word a. We always say a few bottles. Few means more than one. Bottles, S means more than one. So we are going to write here, there are a few bottles of water here. Next one, there is a railway station behind our house. Fifth one, there is a rock in the middle of the road. There are many mangoes on the tree. At the end, I repeat children, if we are talking about one thing or one people, we will start the sentence with there is. And if we are talking about more than one people or more than one thing, then we are going to write there are. We will start the sentence with there are. Okay, children.